Since we've initialized this array with HL in the first part and MW in all the other parts of this array, to enable the queuing, what we're going to do is associate with each lock another variable, which is called the QLast variable. And this QLast variable is initialized to zero. And so these two are the two data structures associated with every lock. So every lock that you have in your program, the operating system is going to assign two data structures for you. One, which is the circular queue represented by the flags array, and the other is the QLast variable, which is saying what is the spot that is available for you to queue yourself in this particular array. So as you can see, since there is no lock request yet, we just initialized the queue, the first guy that comes around to ask for the lock will get it. And he will queue himself here, and he'll get the lock as well. So let's say some processor came along and made a lock request. It's going to get it immediately because there's no locks request currently pending. And so it's got this position, and he's got the lock. And what will happen is that the QLast variable will advance to the next part to indicate that future requesters have to start queuing up from here. And now this current lock holder has got the lock, and he can go off into the critical section and do whatever he wants in terms of managing or messing up with the data structure that is governed by this particular lock. Let's say that at some point of time, I come along and request the same lock. Now, depending on who else got ahead of me at the point that I made that lock request, there may be some number of people that are lined up ahead of me, and wherever QLast is pointing is my place. And so this is where I'm going to queue myself waiting for that lock. And of course, QLast will advance to the next open spot for future requesters that come after me. Now, the important point I want you to notice is that since the array size is n and the number of processes is n, nobody will be denied. Everybody can come and queue up waiting for this lock because since there are n processors, at most n simultaneous requests can be there for that lock, and everybody will get their unique spot to wait for if in fact the lock is currently in use. Given the timing of my lock request and the position of the current lock holder, you can see that I have some waiting to do because there are quite a few requests that are ahead of me. And so I have some waiting to do before I get my turn in acquiring this particular lock. So now I can tell you how the lock algorithm is going to look like. Pretty simple. When I make a lock request, what I'm going to do is mark my place in this flags array. And the way I do that is by calling fetch and increment on the QLast variable. And that ensures that I get my unique spot due to the fetch operation, and I increment the QLast to point to the next spot that's available for the future requesters. And since fetch and increment is an atomic operation, remember that we have read, modify, write operations. Fetch and increment is one of those, and it's an atomic operation. And therefore, even though it's a multiprocessor, there could be multiple guys trying to get the same lock at the same time, they're all going to be sequenced through this fetch and increment atomic operation. And so there is no issue of any race condition in that sense. So I will get my spot, and I'll increment QLast. And of course, if the architecture does not support this fancy fetch and increment read, modify, write operation, then you have to simulate that operation using test and increment instructions. So once I've marked my position in this flags array, then I'm going to basically wait for my turn. So what I do in order to wait is I'm basically waiting for this part that I have marked myself. It is right now must wait. It has to change to HL. Once it changes to HL, I know that I have the lock, and therefore I'm going to do a spin on this particular location, and I'm going to wait for this location changing its value from MW to HL. So that's the spin loop that you see here. So basically, once I have marked my position, I'm going to wait on my position becoming HL to know that I've acquired the lock. And I will get it eventually because that's the way this algorithm is supposed to work.